สวัสดีครับ and good afternoon once again. Today is Friday, the 8th of October, 2021, and this once again is the live broadcast of the press briefing for the summary that we have had in the Thai language version. So we have the summary for you every Monday, Wednesday, and Fridays in the English language version here at the Center for COVID Situation Administration, or CCSA.So first of all, thank you to Dr. Chuetsan Namwat from the Ministry of Public Health for the Thai language briefing. He also mentioned many important issues. After my briefing, we will be having a special guest to speak about COVID in the context of the situation, the new situation that we have now, meaning the floods that we have now. Of course, with all of the natural disasters, all of the various climate change issues. In Thailand right now, we're facing rain in particular provinces and, of course, flooding as well. Now, this might be causing some inconveniences in terms of travel as well as health repercussions as well. So COVID in the context of the situation that we have now in terms of the mass flooding in Thailand. So we'll have that after this briefing.But first of all, I'd like to give you the overall situation currently for today. Overall, I'll start globally first, that we have new infected cases in general in Thailand is now on a downward trend. So you see the infographic on screen right now. It's kind of self-explanatory. Cases per million population. So as per 1 million people, over 200in Thailand have been infected. Now, comparatively with other countries, it does not matter what the population of the country is, but ratio-wise, in terms of per million population, you have the number of infected persons there in the red circle. So comparatively, Thailand is still quite low. Now, in the second chart, the second graph, deaths or fatality rate, deaths per million population, and you see the numbers there that Thailand,is third from the right, but as compared to other countries, even in Asia or our ASEAN countries, neighboring countries, we still stand at a rate which is not very high as per 1 million population. So for while the latest measures put in place since August have been effective in driving down the overall number of new infected cases,particularly in Bangkok and surrounding provinces, new clusters in provinces still emerge. Many new clusters are found in provinces such as Ubon Ratchathani, Chanthaburi, and Sri Sakit. This is mostly from the factory workers and social gatherings, as well as gatherings which are happening a lot in the provinces, such as funerals, religious ceremonies, rituals,as well as from eating meals together. And most prevalent is in the provinces of Thailand. So therefore, just to stress the importance of strictly observing all of the recommended safety measures. In short, don't let your guard down. Now, I'd just like to call your attention to the graph that you see on screen right now. You see red and green and blue. Now, for the overall situation in Thailand, which is in red,on a downward trend, as you can see. Now, the one in dark blue, on a downward trend as well as the months progress. However, if you notice in the green line, it still is kind of stable, more or less in the same level, same direction, same in terms of being flat, not going on a downward trend. So that green portion is for the provinces of Thailand. So that remains the focus for our work. Bangkok is quite okay. Thailand in general is quite okay, but in the terms of the different provinces, not on a downward trend yet. Now, Dr. Chuetsan from the Health Ministry just now reiterated that we are indeed at a crossroads, and it's up to all of us on where we would go from here. If we continue to implement measures, including, of course, the vaccine coverage, the vaccine drive, or number two, the universal prevention measures that we talked about, number three, the use of ATKs, and fourth, the COVID-free setting, we can possibly effectively turn things around and successfully continue with our reopening plans. So we're at a crossroads right now. I'd like to move to the vaccination progress that we have, and we have a slide coming up for you. The update on the number of vaccines administered since the start of our vaccination program. Yesterday, quite a high number. We recorded over 900,000, 911,000, over 911,000 doses of vaccines administered in one day, which was yesterday. So it's almost up to a million per day. This has increased the number of accumulated doses vaccinated to over 58 million doses in Thailand already. To break that down, yesterday alone, over 413,000 received their first dose, and over 454,000 received their second dose. So happy to note that more than 90% of medical staff and healthcare workers have received their booster dose, the third dose as well. In terms of the goal to inoculate 50% of the population in every province by the end of October, there are now 13 provinces in total that have reached that target, meaning inoculated over 50% of the population, with the province of Phetchaburi being the latest addition to provinces in the above 50% level, which include provinces like Bangkok, Pathum Thani, Samut Sakhon, Samut Prakan, Ayutthaya, Phanga, Phuket, and Ranong. So a lot in the central region and some in the southern part of Thailand. So we hope that this list of provinces reaching above 50% inoculation will expand in due course. And another 16 other provinces are also well underway to meet this target. Moving on to the general situation and number of cases that we have for today. New confirmed case standing at 11,140 cases recorded yesterday. You can see that in the blue box on the infographic on screen. New recoveries, we have 9,933 cases. In terms of the active cases still being treated at the moment, we have 110,113, hoping the number will be reduced in due course. We have recorded yesterday 116 fatalities, unfortunately. The fatality rate in Thailand remains at 1.04%. I'll give you some recap on the alternative quarantine system. Information on the alternative quarantine system, and you have there an infographic in English for you. Yesterday, there were around 26 inbound flights from abroad, adding around 918 new arrivals into the alternative quarantine system in Thailand. Just some statistics you see on screen. Currently, 127 hotels remain listed under the alternative quarantine scheme, over 16,000 rooms available for alternative quarantine, with over 4,500 rooms now being occupied and 11,000 rooms remaining vacant. The total number of people being quarantined stands at 5,649 currently. Now, just to recap this, because as you know, in the beginning of the pandemic, the state quarantine and alternative quarantine system was of course a big part of our system. Now of course the situation has changed, it has transitioned, and the alternative quarantine system is still being utilized, but of course there are all of these pilot provinces wherein the quarantine does not have to be in a hotel but within a bubble within the province itself, such as Phuket, as you know. However, the system still remains, of course, for the inbound flights and incoming passengers coming from abroad as per our strict measures in entering Thailand. I'd like to give you some new information, pieces of information, good news actually. The first is about that the government of the United Kingdom is moving Thailand off their red list. The effective this coming Monday, the 11th of October at 4 a.m. onwards, Thailand, along with 46 other countries and territories around the world, will no longer be on the red list of those entering the United Kingdom. This means that if you are traveling from Thailand to the United Kingdom, you will no longer be required to follow the red list rule, including booking a quarantine hotel and taking 2 COVID tests. However, please be mindful that if your arrival date or time is before the cutoff date of 11th of October, this Monday at 4 a.m., you must still follow the red list rules and rules for people who are not fully vaccinated. And you have some information there for you on screen. If your arrival is after that cutoff date and time, you can use a vaccine certificate to prove your vaccination status. So this is quite good news for travelers, Thai or foreign, traveling from Thailand to other countries around the world, and in this case to Europe, to the United Kingdom. Another good news, piece of information, new news, is about the development of the favipiravir syrup. The first favipiravir syrup developed in Thailand. In that the Faculty of Pharmaceutical Sciences at Chulalongkorn University, in collaboration with the Chulalongkorn Royal Academy and private sector, had successfully developed Thailand's first favipiravir syrup for children and patients with COVID-19. So for pediatric patients who need to use the syrup, at present it has been distributed to many hospitals across the country. Registration for this medication can be made on the website favipiravir.cra. That's short for Chulalongkorn Research Academy, .ac.th, without any cost, or directly contact Chulalongkorn Hospital in Bangkok. Now, patients must be in the care of a doctor because the syrup can cause side effects to some patients, as with other types of medication. So after my briefing, we'll have, as I mentioned, experts on COVID coming to talk in our program, in the Thai language program, and we'll pick up the gist and perhaps talk to you about the discussion in the next English language briefing and summary for you. Meanwhile, I hope that all of you continue to stay safe, all of you continue to follow the measures that we have. The CCSA continues to work hard for all of you. As you know, that October is a crossroads month. In the beginning of October, we relax many measures. We're looking towards 2 weeks or 14 days after October, which is next week, to review all of these relaxation of measures, whether to continue them or adjust them further. So middle of the month, next week, we'll be having the general CCSA meeting to evaluate our past measures in these past 14 days. The general CCSA meeting next week will be chaired by His Excellency the Prime Minister of Thailand. So with that note, I thank you for your attention, and I hope you the very best of health, and we will see you again next time. สวัสดีครับ
ครับขอบพระคุณนะครับท่าน